Hi students, welcome to Smarter Everyday Overlearning. Dear students, I've been teaching for you the classes from the chapter Chemical Bonding and the Molecular Structure for NEET series. In our previous class, only 8 questions I explained to you, and who didn't see that class, that link I'll give in the description, you can go through that class. Okay students, this is the continuation class from yesterday's topic. Let's see with the question, 8th question. Yesterday I left this question. Let's begin this session with this topic. Let's begin the today's session with the question, which of the following pairs of species have the same bond order? Dear students, this question completely basing upon the molecular orbital electronic configuration and the bond order. Okay students, let's see one by one by the calculation of the bond orders. Let's see one by one, dear students. First one, option A, O2 and NO plus. Here for O2 molecule, we can see. Let's see for all these options, what is the molecular orbital electronic configurations and the bond order values. Option 1, that is option A, O2. Here you can see for O2 molecule, sigma 1s2 and sigma star 1s2. Sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, sigma 2pz2, pi 2px2 is equal to pi 2py2, pi star 2px1 is equal to pi star 2py1. This is the electronic configuration. Basing upon this, you need to calculate the bond order for these students. For that one formula is there, basing upon this molecular orbital electronic configurations. NB minus NA. This is bonding orbitals and anti-bonding orbitals. We can consider basing upon this electronic configuration. Here students, an NB, nothing but bonding orbitals. Here how many we need to find out? 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, these are 10. Minus anti-bonding orbitals, how many we have to find out, which are having the stars here. Sigma star, we need to find out 2, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, 6, 10 minus 6. That is half into 4. That is 2. Okay, students, for the bond order O2 molecule, that is we got it 2. And let's see the next one. This is the electronic configuration of NO plus ion. Sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2. Sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, sigma 2pz2 and pi 2px2 is equal to pi 2py2. And basing upon this, we need to find out the bond order for this. The same formula we need to calculate, NB minus NA. Let's see the calculation. In this, the bond order, how many the bonding orbitals? These are the antibonding orbitals. Okay, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay students, half into 10 minus, here we can calculate the antibonding orbitals, 2 and plus 2, 4. Okay, 10 minus 4. So that is half into 6, 3. The bond order should be 3 here. Okay students, let's see the next option, option B here. This is for option A, option B, Cn minus. For Cn minus, basing upon the molecular orbital electronic configuration, let's see. Sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, pi 2px2 is equal to pi 2py2 and pi 2pz2. Okay, and here we need to find out the bond order, half into antibonding and bonding orbitals. We need to find out the bonding orbitals first. Let us see for Cn minus. Okay, 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 minus the antibonding orbitals, here only 2. 10 minus 2. This is nothing but half into 8. Half into 8. Oh, sorry, here 4. Here 4. That means half into 6 here. So 3 is the bond order for Cn minus. Let's see the next one. Next option, option B, CO. For CO also, we can calculate the bond order. For CO, sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, pi 2p x2 is equal to pi 2p y2 sigma 2p z2. Okay students, for this we need to find out the bond order, half into bonding orbitals. How many we need to count? 2 plus 2 4 6 7 8 9 10 10 minus antibonding orbitals. Here you can see only 4, that is half into 10 minus 4, that is 6. So half into 6, 3. Here also 3 we got the answer. Here also 3 for CO. Let's do for the option C. Here what we have, option C, N2 and O2 minus. Okay, for this also we need to find out the bond order basing upon that molecular orbital electronic configuration. Sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, pi 2p x2 is equal to pi 2p y2. Why? Because these are in same degenerating orbital, so these are in same level. Sigma 2p z2. Okay, for this the bond order, half into the bonding orbitals. How many students? 2 plus 2 4 6. Here 10 bonding orbitals, 10, and minus antibonding orbitals, those are 4. 10 minus 4, so that is 6. Half into 6, here 3. For N2 molecule, we have the answer 3, that is the bond order. Let's see the next one, next option, O2 minus. For this also, basing upon that molecular orbital energy level diagram, we need to find out the electronic configuration and bond order. Sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, sigma 2p z2, pi 2p x2 is equal to sigma 2p y2, pi star 2p x2, pi star 2p y1. Okay, basing upon this, for the bond order, half into bonding orbitals minus antibonding orbitals. Let's calculate for these students the bonding orbitals. How many we have? 2 4 6 8 10. Okay, 10 minus antibonding orbitals, 4 6 and 7. 10 minus 7, that is half into 10 minus 7, 0.5. this is the answer for O2 minus. And let's go for next one, option D. What we have, the molecule, that is CO. For CO, we need to find out the bond order. We have done it already. This is for CO, 3 is the bond order, what we have got here. Then for CO, we got the answer, that is 3. And the next one, what we have, that is NO. For NO, that electronic configuration is sigma 1s2, sigma star 1s2, and sigma 2s2, sigma star 2s2, sigma 2p z2, and pi 2p x2 is equal to pi 2p y2 and pi star 2p x1. Pi star 2p x1. This is the configuration. Okay students, for the bond order, half into bonding orbitals, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. 10 bonding orbitals and antibonding orbitals here, 4, 5. Okay students, then half into 5. 2.5 is the answer here. Okay, let's see the question. Which of the following pairs of species have the same bond order? Now, what we have the answers for O2 here, 2. For NO plus here, 3. For CN minus also 3. And CO also 3 here. Okay, for N2 also 3 here. For O2 minus 1.5. For NO 2.5. Then the answer is, which one is the correct one? You have to identify 3, 3 for NO plus and CO, CN minus is the same answer. So option B is the correct one, which are having the same answer. 3 is the bond order. Let's do it for the question, next question, that is the 10th question here. Questions of atomic orbitals of nitrogen in NO2 plus and NO3 minus and NH4 plus respectively are. Here some options given. Let's see which one is the correct one. For this, you need to have the formula to find out the hybridization, X is equal to half into number of valency electrons plus monoatomicity minus cation plus anion. This is the formula. Basing upon this, we need to identify which option is the correct one. What they have given in the question, that is first one, NO2+. For this, you need to identify the X value for NO2+. Okay, students, let's do it. X is equal to, here valency electrons. Nitrogen is the central atom here. Then for nitrogen, atomic number is 7. Its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. So this is the K shell, this is the L shell. So this is the valency shell. Then valency electrons are here, how many students? Those are 2+3, that is 5, the number 5. Half into valence electrons plus monoatomicity. Monoatomicity, here we have an ion, so we can ignore this simply. Monoatomicity, we can take it as 0. Then minus, here students only plus ion, so the cation charge we can take it as 1. Okay, there is no anion, we can consider this. Then half into 4, that is the answer 2, we got it. Then if the value of X is 3, sorry, 2 we have here, value of X is 2, the hybridization should be sp hybridization. That only we need to write here, that is sp hybridization. Let's do it. The next one, NO, in the question what we have, NO3-. Okay students, for this we need to do it, NO3-. Here also students, the central atom is nitrogen only, then we need to do for nitrogen central atom, so we can take it as same previous, half into 5 plus, this 5 is the valence electrons, and monoatomicity here also same 0. And here we can ignore C and we can take anion. Why? Because here minus ion they have given, so plus 1. Then students, half into 6, so 3. Then if the X value is 3, what is the hybridization we have? That is sp2. Okay, we need to write that sp2 hybridization. Let's do it for the next one, NH4. Here NH4 plus ion we have. Here also nitrogen is the central atom, NH4 plus ion, nitrogen is the central atom. Then the same values we have to take here, X is equal to half into 5 is the number of valence electrons, and plus, here students you can see monoatomicity hydrogen, then 4, minus cation. So here what we have, the plus charge, so cation we need to take minus 1. Okay students, that is half into 9 minus 1, that is 8. So the answer is 4. If the X value is 4, the hybridization should be sp3. Okay students, this is sp3 hybridization. Now we have the answer, what is that correct one? Here first one, sp, sp2 and sp3. Then option C, sp, sp2 and sp3. This is the correct answer, option C. Let's see the next one, 11th question. Which of the following pairs of ions is isoelectronic and isostructural? This is also basing upon the counting of electrons. We need to find out the answer for this 11th one. We should do it. See the options here, CO3 2-. For all options, we need to calculate the number of electrons. Then only we need to identify the which one is the correct one. Okay students, here let's do it. For CO3 2-. For option A, I'm doing here. Basing upon this formula only, basing upon X is equal to half into valence electrons plus monovalent atoms and minus cation plus anion charge. Basing upon that, we need to calculate this also. Here the central atom is carbon. Okay, carbon atomic number is 6. Electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p2. Okay, students, here. Four are the valence electrons here, and this is atomicity. Here O2 is diatomic molecule, so that we need to take it as zero. And this is only anion we have, so for the cation, in the instead of cation place, we can take it zero. And plus for anion here 2 minus, so plus 2 we need to take. Then the final answer is 3. If the x value is 3, the hybridization should be sp2. Okay students, sp2. Then for this, the structure is trigonal, then the shape is trigonal planar here. And for next option, NO3 minus, here we can take the nitrogen as the central atom. Electronic configuration 1s2 2s2 2p3, basing upon its atomic number. Here students, half into 5, these 5 are the valence electrons, plus 0. This 0 is monovalent atom, so here there is no monovalent atom, so that we can take it as 0. And this is anion here, so 1 is the charge. Then here also we have the hybridization is sp2. Then students, for calculating the electrons here, we need to do it for electrons here. See, for nitrogen 7 electrons, and here for O3, O3 means 8 into 3, and 1 minus is there, so you need to add plus 1. That means you need to add 1 electron for this. Then 7 plus 24 plus 1, so 32. Here the structure is trigonal planar. And students, for this also, CO3 2 minus, you need to calculate that number of electrons here. I am going to do here, let's see. For carbon, there are 6 electrons plus how many oxygens here? 3. So 3 into 8. Okay, here 2 minus, so you need to add plus 2 here. This is also 6 plus 24 plus 32. Okay, then plus 2 here, then the total is 32, that is sp2 hybridization. Okay students, here we got the answer 32 electrons, and here also 32 electrons. And let's go for next one, option B, ClO3 minus. Option B, ClO3 minus. Directly we can do by calculating the number of electrons, the total number of electrons. For chlorine is the 17, and oxygen, here 3 oxygens are there, then 8 into 3, then here 1 minus, you need to add plus 1. Then 17 plus 24 plus 1 here, that is 42. Then if you calculate the x value here students, you have sp3 hybridization. Then the structure will be trigonal pyramidal. And let's go for next one. The next option is CO3 2 minus. CO3 2 minus. For the calculation of electrons here, let's do it. Carbon, the total number of electrons are 6 here, and oxygens the same, like this only, 24 plus here. Here we have anion, so 24 here 2 minus, then you need to add plus 2 for this. Then the total is 32. Then this is sp2 hybridization. Okay students, the total electrons are here 32. And let's see the next one, option C, SO3. What we have here, SO3 2 minus and NO3 minus. And let's see for that, SO3 2 minus. Okay students, for this we need to find out the total number of electrons here. For sulfur, there are 16 electrons plus here O3, as same 24, and minus 2 is there, so you need to add plus 2 here. The total is 42 electrons, what we have previously here, 42 electrons. Then the hybridization should be sp3, the same structure, trigonal pyramidal. Okay students, and next one, NO3 minus. For this also, nitrogen 7 electrons plus oxygen 24, here 1 minus is there, so you need to add plus 1 here, so 32 electrons, that is sp2 hybridization. Then trigonal planar. same trigonal planar. Okay, students, these are neither isoelectronic nor isostructural. And let's see for next one, ClO3. Option D, what we have? Option D, ClO3. And this VDD already, ClO3 minus VDD already, 42 electrons we got it. And next one is SO3 2 minus. For this, we need to do here SO3 2 minus, also we have 42. So, students, these are isoelectronic as well as isostructural. Then the option A and D, we can take it as correct. Option A and option D also, we have here same number of electrons, 32 and 42 here. So these two options we take it as correct. And next one, students, let's see the correct geometry and hybridization for XeF4 xenon tetrafluoride are options they have given, octahedral, and some hybridizations they have given. Let's see which one is the correct one. And number 12, let's see, first of all you need to have the structure of xenon tetrafluoride. It will be xenon is the central atom and the surrounding atoms are fluorine. This is the structure for xenon tetrafluoride. Here the lone pair of electrons, here also same two electrons. Then it is sp3d2 hybridization, students, and the structure should be, the geometry is octahedral. Then this is square planar shape. Then option A, octahedral, sp3d2 is the correct one. Let's see the next one, 13th question. What we have among the following, which one is wrong statement? Okay, students, wrong statement you need to identify. Option A, ph5 and bicl5 do not exist, and d pi bonds are present in SO2, and the next one, SeF4 and CH4 have the same shape. I3 plus has bent geometry. Let's see here, students, option C, wrong statement we need to identify. So these, basing upon its valency electrons and valency, these two are not exist, and p pi d pi bonds are present in SO2. This statement is correct only. And option C, SeF4 and CH4 have same shape. So these are having, let's see what's the shape they have, then only we can identify which one is the correct one. For SeF4, there are 4 fluorines, 3 and 4. Here, students, one single pair of electron, the structure sp3 dehybridization, and the shape is seesaw. And for methane, the shape is like this. Methane hybridization is sp3 tetrahedral shape. Then option C is the correct. Let's see question number 14. Consider the molecule CH4 and H3H2O. Which of the following statements are false? Okay, then students, for these three molecules you need to draw the structures for these. Let's do it, and afterwards we can see the options what we have. The first one, CH4, this is the structure for CH4. Then students, bond angle is 109 degrees 28 minutes. Okay, and next one, NH3. For NH3 molecule, the structure we need to see like this. This is NH3, and here one lone pair of electrons should be presented, and here the bond angle is 107 degrees. Okay, students, and the next one is H2O, the water molecule. Here should be oxygen, and here two hydrogens, and here two lone pair of electrons are present. Okay, the bond angle here 104.5 degrees. Okay, now let us see the options. The water molecule bond angle in H2O, that is HOH bond angle, is less than HNH bond angle of NH3. Okay, then that is bond angle this is less than the bond angle of NH3. So this is the correct one only. We need to identify the false one. Then see, let's see next one. The HCH bond angle in CH4 is greater than HNH bond angle in NH3. Okay, this is also correct one. Then option C, the HCH bond angle in CH4, the HOH bond angle in H2O greater than 90 degrees. So correct only. Let's see the next one is the HOH bond angle in H2O is larger than HCH bond angle in CH4, methane. Okay, this is the statement wrong. So option D is the correct one. Let's see question number 15. Predict the correct order among the following. Here students, some bond pair greater than lone pair and lone pair, some options given. For these students, you need to know the theory of VSEPR theory. V-S-E-P-R theory. According to this theory, the repulsive force between the lone pair repulsion, it is greater than the repulsion between lone pair and bond pair. Okay, then which are further greater than the bond pair and lone pair? Let's see which one is the correct one. What I said here, that is lone pair and lone pair greater than lone pair greater than bond pair, bond pair, that is the correct one. The repulsions, repulsive forces. Okay students, that is basing upon VSEPR theory. And let's see number 16th question. In which of the following pairs both the species are not isostructural? Not isostructural, we need to see all of these structures. And in diamond and silicon carbide, see option A, the central atom is in sp3 hybridization students, hence these two are isostructural. Okay, and NH3 and PH3, both are, these two are pyramidal, and here the central atom in both cases in sp3 hybridization. Okay students, and silicon tetrachloride SiCl4, that is an option 4, and PCl4+, both are in tetrahedral. And here the central atom in both cases, that is in sp3 hybridization. And students, for option C, that is XeF4, and here the xenon is in sp3d2 hybridization, and structure is square planar, while in XeO4 xenon is sp3, here xenon sp3 hybridization, then structure of XeO4 is tetrahedral. Then option C is the correct one. Let's see the XeF4 and XeO4, the structures are like this. And here students, the shapes explained to you, sp3d2 hybridization, and in XeO4 sp3 hybridization, which are having the shapes of square planar and tetrahedral. These are the shapes you can see here. Then option C is the correct one. And let's see the next one. Decreasing order of stability of O2, O2 minus and O2 plus and O2 2 minus is. Here some options given. We need to find out which one is the correct one. Basing upon molecular orbital energy level diagram, you need to identify the electronic configuration for all of these ions. And for O2, here the total number of electrons are 16. Then students, this is the electronic configuration. Basing upon this, we need to find out the bond order. The formula, half into bonding orbitals minus antibonding orbitals. Bonding orbitals we need to calculate here. 2, 4, 6, 7, 8. 8 minus antibonding orbitals, 2, 1, 1. Those are 4. So answer is 2. The bond order of O2 is 2 we have. And see, let's see the next one. Here what we have, O2 2 minus. For O2 2 minus, there are only 18 electrons. The configuration is like this. And for this bond order, half into bonding orbitals, here how many we need to find out? 8 minus 6. Then the answer is 1. Here bonding orbitals 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay? And here star, that means antibonding orbitals 2, 4, 6. Then answer we got here 1. And let's see the next one. O2 minus, here there are 17 electrons and this is the electronic configuration basing upon Euler orbital energy level diagram. Here bond order we need to find out, half into for O2 minus, here 8 minus 5, bonding orbitals are 8 here and antibonding orbitals 5 here. Then the answer is 8 minus 5, that is 3, 1.5 is the answer. Let's see the next one. One ion is left over, that is O2 plus. Okay, here total number of electrons, students, 15 electrons. Okay, then why? Because O2 is 16, O2 16 electrons and plus is there, this is the ion, then we need to subtract 1 from 15. Let's see the configuration. These are antibonding orbitals here. Then we need to find out the bond order for these, half into bonding orbitals minus antibonding orbitals for 8 minus 3. These are antibonding orbitals. Then students, answer is half into 5, that is 2.5 is the answer for this. As bond order is inversely proportional. It is directly proportional to the stability, not inversely, it is directly proportional to the stability. The decreasing order of stability is, so students, basing upon all of these bond orders, the decreasing order of the stability we need to find out, that is O2 plus greater than O2 greater than O2 2 minus O2 2 minus. Okay students, this is the answer for this, and the option D is the correct one. I hope you have understood this one. Let's see the next question of 18th one, basing upon what we have done previously, that is the 7th question. The correct bond order in the following species is, here some options given. Here the bond orders, basing upon the previous question, we need to identify that. Option B is the correct one. Here for option B, O2 minus, that bond order is 1.5, and here O2 plus, that is 2.0, and the next one O2 minus. Here students, for next one is O2 2 plus, this is bond order is 3.0, and the next one is O2 plus, the bond order is 2.5. Then correct one is O2 minus. This is the correct order. So the bond order in the following species is, this one is less than symbols. This is the correct one. Let's see the next one. Maximum bond angle at nitrogen present in which of the following? Here students, NO2 plus and NO3 minus, NO2, NO2 minus. Then for this you need to know the tabular form of species which are having here, and for this hybridization, and students, for NO3 this is sp2 hybridization, here also sp2 and here also sp2, this is only sp, the structure of linear. Okay students, and the bond angles, here 120 degrees, here 134 degrees, 115, here 180. Okay students, now so NO2 plus has the maximum bond angle here. NO2 plus the maximum bond angle here. This is the correct answer. Then students, let's see the next question. This is the last one for this today's session. Which of the following molecules has the maximum dipole momentum? Okay, students, for maximum dipole momentum, then here you need to see the structures for this CO2, here O, C and O. Dipole momentum should be like this. This is mu is equal to 0 and this is symmetrical. And let's see for CH4, the structure should be like this. These are all hydrogens here and dipole momentum towards the carbon. You see here mu is equal to 0. This is also symmetrical. And for NH3 ammonia, structure should be here the lone pair of electrons here, three hydrogens like this, and towards the nitrogen the dipole momentum here mu is not equal to 0. This is pyramidal. Okay, and let's see the next one, NF3 N, and here should be the lone pair of electrons here, fluorines, NF3 here towards the nitrogen, the dipole momentum here also mu is not equal to 0. This is pyramidal. Okay students, basing upon this we can say that in NH3 hydrogen less electronegative than nitrogen, and hence dipole momentum of each N and H bond is towards nitrogen and create high net dipole momentum, whereas in NF3 F is more electronegative than N. The dipole momentum of NF bond is opposite to the lone pair, hence reducing the dipole momentum. And C, students, option C is the correct one. Okay, this is about the today's session, students. What we have discussed, remaining 12 questions explained to you, and what are your views. And if you understand this class, you can share to your friends, and please subscribe to my channel for my further NEET classes. You can practice all of these. Okay students, your views and your doubts you can convey in the comment section. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.